Good afternoon. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about frequent item set. What is frequent item set? What is the confidence? What is the support? And the mining assertion. Today we are going to discuss about mining assertion rules. There are two step approaches are there. First one is frequent item set generation. Generate all item sets support is greater than or equal to minimum support. And second step is in this is rule generation. Generate the high confidence rules from each frequent item set. That is, for the rules that are having confidence which is greater than minimum confidence level. But frequent item set generation is still a computationally expensive task. Now we are going to see about frequent item set generation for 5 elements or 5 items. So A, B, C, D, E are the items. And if you have created one item set, then we have item set A, B, C, D, E. And if you have created two item sets, we are having a item sets, that is candidate item sets A, B, A, C, A, D, A, E, B, C, B, D, B, E, C, E, CD and DE. And if you are considering for 3 item sets, then we will have ABC, ABD, ABE, ACD, ACE, etc. And if you are considering for 4 item set, we have ABCD, ABCE. So like this it goes. And so if you are considering 5 item set, ABCDE. So given D items, there are 2 raised to D possible candidate items. In this case, D is equal to 5. So we'll have total 2 raised to 5, that is 32 item sets or candidate item sets are possible. And for each item set, we need to generate we need to compute the support in order to find out that frequent item set whether it is having a support or not. And this is a computationally expensive task. So that's why the brute force approach is not very suitable. So in brute force approach, what we are doing is each item set in the lattice is a candidate frequent item set. We need to count the support of each candidate by scanning the database. We need to find out what is the support count. Then finally, we need to list the candidates who are having minimum support. And this is a very very complex. The complexity will be order of n, nmw. Where n is the number of transactions and w is the number of items and m is the number of elements. And so it is equal to, the complexity is equal to 2 raised to d. And frequent item set generation strategies, there are 3 different strategies which can be used. One is reduce the number of candidates, because there is a possibility that the maximum D elements are there, means the number of candidates will be 2 raised to D. So but what we can do is we can use some pruning techniques to reduce the number of M. Second technique is reduce the number of transactions. So this, if you are decreasing the transaction by making use of some algorithms, we can reduce it. Third way is reducing number of comparisons by means of some efficient data structures to store the candidates or transactions. So no need to match every candidate against every transaction. Thereby, we can reduce the number of comparisons. And in our first approach, we are going to see about reducing the number of candidates. And here, one principle is used, which is called as a apriori principle. So based on the prior knowledge, we are generating the item sets, candidate item set. We are reducing the number of candidates. If an item set is a frequent, so this apriori principle says, if an item set is frequent, then all of its subsets are must also be frequent. If an item set is frequent, then all its subsets also be frequent. So apriori principle, if you are representing in mathematical representation for all x comma y, where x is a subset of y, then support of x will be always greater than or equal to support of y. Support of item set never exceeds the support of its subset. That is what is the property, and this property is known as anti-monotone property. And the same thing if you are saying in different way. So if some item sets which are infrequent, then their supersets also infrequent. For example, consider an example here. AB is a item set, candidate item set, which is found to be infrequent because which is not having enough support. Then its superset, so its supersets are ABC, ABD, ABE, ABCD, ABCE, ABDE, ABCDE, pruned superset, which is also called as a pruned superset. They are also infrequent. So thereby we can reduce the number of candidate item sets. So we need not to consider ABC, ABD, ABE, all these possibilities. We can just simply we can eliminate. Now let us see how we can illustrate this apriori principle. So given transaction sets, transactions having 5 transactions and along with the items purchased is shown in this table. And here we have generated the one item sets. So item bread, coke, milk, beer, diaper, X. So we need to compute the support. So here minimum support is equal to 3. Now bread. So bread, how many transactions bread is occurred or bread is purchased. Now we have bread once, twice, thrice and 4 times. That's why the count is 4. Coke, which is occurred twice. Milk, 4 times. Beer, 3 times. And here we can eliminate those items which are having minimum support, which are not having minimum support. That is Coke, which is having a support of 2, and X, which are having a support of 1. So here, if you are actually considering all the subsets, so total 6 items are there. If you are going for one item set, then 6C1 will have so many candidate items. And if you are considering for 2 item set, then we have 6C2 item sets, that is equal to 15. And if you are considering for 3 item sets, so 6C3 is 20, but which is total equal to 40. But by the use of support based pruning, we can reduce to 16. Let us see how we can do it. Now here, after reducing the one item sets, so one item set become bread, milk, beer and diaper. From there, we need to generate 2 item sets. So we can exclude these Coke and egg. So now possible pairs will be, item set pairs will be bread and milk, bread and beer, bread and diaper, Next will be beer and milk, then diaper and milk, then beer and diaper. And again, we need to compute the support count. So, which elements are having support which is equal to 3 means whether bread and milk together, how many times it is occurring in a transaction? Bread and milk. So, bread and milk once, bread and milk twice, bread and milk thrice, 3 times. So, that's why the support count need to be computed. So, here bread and milk is having support count 3, beer and bread is having support count 2, bread and diaper 3, beer and milk 2, diaper and milk 3, beer and diaper is having support of 3. So, thereby, by pruning, we can reduce it to 6 items. From 6, again, we need to compute. Thereby, we can eliminate these two pairs, that is beer and bread and beer and milk, because which is not having enough support. In the next level, we can form the triplets. Now, from this, we have to consider bread, milk, bread, diaper, milk, diaper, beer and diaper. So, we have to form triplets, that is 3 item sets. So, if you are considering beer, diaper, milk, so beer, diaper, milk, so one possibility, beer, diaper, bread, then bread, diaper, milk, beer, bread, milk. So, these triplets we need to compute and find out, we need to compute the support count. But here, the minimum support count we are not achieving. So, we are achieving only the support count 2. So, that's why. And also, this can be directly removed by means of a priori principle. Bread, diaper, milk. Because bread and milk, which is not having minimum support, that's why directly we can eliminate this candidate before computing the support count, that we are going to discuss in detail in the subsequent lecture. Now, let us see what is a priori algorithm. So, which is an algorithm which is used to find the frequent item sets. A priori is a seminal or decisive algorithm proposed by R. Agarwal and R. Srikanth in 1994 for mining frequent item sets for the association rules. The name of the algorithm is based on the fact that the algorithm uses the prior knowledge of frequent item set properties. And here, it uses an iterative approach where level-wise search will be done, where k items are used to explore next k plus 1 items. First, we are computing frequent one item set by scanning the entire database and which supports the minimum support count, and resulting the set will be denoted by L1. Next, L1 is used to find L2, that is set of frequent 2 items, which is used to find L3, and so on. We are continuously computing the k frequent items, so until there is no more frequent item set which satisfy the minimum support. Likewise, we need to repeat. And if you are representing this in an algorithm way, f of k is frequent k item set, l of k is represented as a candidate k item set. So, the algorithm goes like this. Initially, k will be initialized to 1. Then, we need to generate frequent k item set, that is frequent 1 item sets. And we need to compute the support count and repeat until f of k is empty. So, first we need to do is candidate generation. So, generate the next level candidates from the previous level, that is frequent 1 item set, we need to generate frequent 2 item sets. So, like this it goes. Then in the second level, second step is we need to do the candidate pruning. So prune candidate item sets in the next level, which contains subsets of length k that are infrequent. Whichever are infrequent, we need to eliminate. Next, we need to compute the support count. Count the support of each candidate in LK plus 1 by scanning the database. Finally, candidate elimination. Eliminate candidates in the next level that are infrequent, leaving only those are frequent. So they will form the FK plus 1 frequent item sets. And this we need to repeat until we will get a F of K, that is frequent K item sets, which is empty. So this is the ending condition for our algorithm. Now, let us see with an example. Now, consider a transaction which is having the items listed, which is shown in the table. There are total 9 transactions are there, and the items are listed. So, minimum support is equal to 2 here. So minimum support value is equal to 2. That is, support is actually equal to 2 by 9. So 2 by 9 is approximately 22%. Now, in the a priori algorithm, we need to scan the entire data base for different transactions and count each of the candidates. So that is generating the candidate item set. So now here, by scanning through, we will come to know that there are total 5 items: i1, i2, i5, i4, i3, and remaining are repeating. So next task is to compute the support count. So how many transactions i1 has occurred? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 times. And how many times I2 has occurred? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 times. Next is, how many times I3 has occurred? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I4, 1, 2. I5, 1, 2. So next is, compare the candidate support count with the minimum support count. Now here minimum support count is given is 2. That's why all will be eligible for the 1 frequent item sets. So L1 is equal to all I1, I2, I3, I4, I5. And this frequent item set is used to generate 2 frequent item sets. Now let us see. This is the result from the previous step. Now we need to generate 2 frequent item set. So here we are going to use joining. Joining means we need to take as a pair I1, I2, I1, I3. See here, I1, I2. I1, I2, I1, I3, I1, I4, I1, I5. Next, I2, I3, I2, I4, I2, I5. Next is I3, I4, I3, I5. Next possibility is I4, I5. So we have formed the candidate item sets. Next, we need to compute the support. How many transactions I1 and I2 occurred together? So I1, I2 once, I1, I2 twice, I1, I2 thrice, I1, I2 four times. Similarly, I1 and I3, I1 and I3, which is occurring, I1, I3 once, twice, three times, I1 and I3 four times. So likewise, we need to compute the support count. The next step is eliminate those item sets which are not having minimum support. So here we need to eliminate this item set. Then one more, I3, I4, I3, I5, I4, I5. So we will get the item sets I1, I2, I1, I3, all the item sets which are having minimum support. So that we need to list. From this list, we need to generate the next level, that is generating three frequent item sets. And while joining these three frequent item sets, the possibilities are I1, I2, I3, I1, I2, I5, next I1, I3, I5, next I2, I3, I5, I2, I3, sorry, I2, I4, I5. So these are the possibilities. Now, here we have to use a priori principle, which says that if the subset is infrequent, then supersets also infrequent. Now here you can observe I3, I4 is infrequent. So I3, I4 is infrequent. That's why this we can eliminate. Then one more is I1 and I4, which is occurring together. I1, I4, any not there. Then next is I3, I5. I3, I5. We can eliminate this I3, I5. I3, I5. And here I3, I5. Then next is I4, I5. Any I4, I5. We can eliminate this. So we can eliminate I3, I5, I4, I5. I3, I4, I1, I4, which is infrequent. That's why its superset is also infrequent according to the a priori principle. So now the candidate for the three frequent item sets are I1, I2, I3, I1, I2, I5. And next level is we need to scan in the database. So how many times this I1, I2, I3 occurred in the transaction. So it is coming as twice. Support count is 2. Next is I1, I2, I5, which is also 2. So next, compare the candidate with the minimum support is 2. That's why this will be the 3 frequent item set. So next level is, from this we need to form, we need to go for the next level. So 4 item set, that is I1, I2, I3, I5. So how many times it is there? I1, I2, only once. So it is not meeting the minimum support. That's why we will get a empty set. So here our algorithm will terminate. I hope you understood this. Now, if you are representing this in a mathematical representation and algorithm way, initially k is equal to 1. So find all frequent item, 1 item sets, then increase the k value, 2 item set, generate the candidate item sets for each transaction, identify all candidates belongs to the transaction, then increment the support count, and whichever is having the minimum support, extract the frequent k items, and this we need to repeat until f of k, which is equal to pi, means null. So in this way we can generate the frequent item sets using a priori algorithm. Thank you for listening.